Now, classic body type is very balanced. Yin and yang mixed together. They look amazing with smooth and well-groomed hair and blunt-edged symmetrical cuts. They don't look as good in extremes. Too layered, too trendy, too severe or too boyish, too wild, too ornate coiffé, too lavish or too stiff-teased, you know? The middle, the symmetry, something very exact, looks amazing on them. And let's see some examples. Grace Kelly. Of course she knew what exactly fitted her. You would not see her with straight bangs or super layered hairstyle or super coiffé or super extremes. So I didn't find any pictures of her with bangs. Her face was always opened. Let's look at Diana Sawyer. When we look at more sculpted hairstyles of her with longer side swept bangs, I think that looked better on her. That looked so calm, made her face very clear and clean looking. And as soon as she had the bangs, that 90s bangs, wispy bangs, I think she lost it a little bit, just lost a little bit of that chic. January Jones. Now that's a very interesting situation. Here she is trying that natural and flamboyant natural hairstyle. Long tousled hair with long curtain bangs. Nice, right? Same thing I can say about her earrings here. So she's kind of trying that natural style on her. Okay, let's leave it for the future. Let's not make any considerations now because she still looks nice, right? Now let's look at her with her girly bangs. Wispy, slightly above the brows. That adds a lot of simplicity to her look from my viewpoint. And she still looks cute. Another girly bangs. Kind of girly, long bangs. A bit wispy, natural, slightly tousled hair, not sculpted. Now let's look at this example. A bit too much of makeup. If you've seen my makeup for the body types video, you know what I mean, right? Hair is nice, but then she has that straight bangs again. Here she has that also kind of girly, rounded bangs. Nice makeup, you would say. Clean lines on her outfit. Okay, good. From my opinion, that simplifies her and that is making her very random, unless she has no bangs. Now we're gonna see her. This is what I mean by her. When she doesn't have any bangs, that gives that royalty. Look at how different she looks with no bangs. And it's same person. Look at that overall effect. Look at those classic facial features that are not coming forward, that are not over the top. They're not super feminine, but not super dramatic. Everything is very balanced. Everything is right there in the middle. So she doesn't need that distraction from those clear facial features. All those things, bangs, hanging here, something here, a lot of different makeup things, all that is adding so much noise. If same attributes on other body type, you would not even notice them. That would fit on this classic bone structure that does look like a noise, does look distracting, and is asking for clear look, clean lines. And we don't care about how big her forehead is, because that is image identity. This is head to toe look. Now if we add some drama to classic, we get dramatic classic. They are still very balanced. They look more adult, if I can say so. They have broader or sharper bones in face and in the body. They can be slightly taller. They just look slightly more powerful. They look best in sculpted, angular, geometric hairstyles. Something angular looks best on them. They don't look as good in boyish hairstyles and also too rounded, too feminine, too wild or too ornate. Nina Dobrev, I think on both of these pictures she looks good. I love that bob very much in both cases, when it's with that heavy bangs and when it doesn't have any bangs at all. I love that the cut is very chopped off, that it doesn't have any wispy hair and too much layering. Here she has that very sculpted and sleek hairstyle with straight bangs, and I also like it because her bone structure can pull this off. I think this look is pretty clean. Also these two pictures, yeah, I like her on both of them because of the sculpted look. What I think doesn't fit her as good is these hairstyles. That very girly, wispy and not very sculpted look with those hanging earrings as well. She's still beautiful and cute girl in this picture, but she's lacking her own essence, I think, here. Yeah, she does look like that very pretty girl who is going on school ball. And also she had that 60s photo shoot. I love that very much. She doesn't wear that type of makeup very often, so I think I could hardly recognize her in those pictures, to be honest. 60s were all about the contrast. Now we have three Olivias. The old dramatic classics. Olivia Munn, Olivia Palermo, and Olivia Wilde. So let's look on Olivia Munn now. Let's look on her without any bangs. And I think she looks very sophisticated with no bangs. With that sleek hair and symmetrical parting right in the center. I think she looks gorgeous in that. I think she looks a bit better with central parting than on this picture. It's more like for natural looks. On the side, asymmetrical. But still, what I love about it, it's very clear. And that's her with bangs. These bangs are slightly really wispy and slightly short. So I think the visual weight of the bangs like that is smaller than the visual weight of the body and the bone structure. So I think it doesn't fit her very well. I think it doesn't look chic enough. So she's kind of trying here to look more like a natural rather than dramatic classic. Olivia Palermo, she loves fashion, she loves style. She's thinking through her look all the time. She rarely has any bangs. In a majority of her pictures, she is wearing rather sleek hair with central parting or hair in the back or just that very clean and sculpted straight hair. I love it very much. Her hair is very well groomed all the time, so she knows that she looks better in that kind of hair. I found a couple of pictures of her when she tried to soften her look. On this picture, she is wearing light hair color, so it kind of blends with her tanned skin. It doesn't create that contrast anymore. And also that very natural long bangs. Also looks fine, I think, but again, it doesn't have that chic anymore. And in this picture also, even though she has very contrasted makeup a la 60s, that hair and that bangs, she's kind of trying some flamboyant natural style. Classics normally just have a different vibe. Their bone structure is clearer and more symmetrical for that type of wildness. Olivia Wilde, some stylists say she has pretty long forehead and she has square face or rectangular face. So she kind of has to hide all that stuff. So she's wearing bangs pretty often. Sometimes that girly straight bangs like here. Looks nice. She looks pretty. A bit girly, simple, but still nice. Here also she has pretty girly, not very glamorous, like more simple look, more natural look. Here, on this picture, I like that fringe better because it's more precise, more angular, more like a statement. I like that sleek hair on the back and I like the makeup. So I think it's much more dramatic classic. So on this picture, she's wearing more like a natural hairstyle. That's another difference between naturals and classics. That type of natural hairstyle brings more chic to natural girls, but it takes away some chic from classic girls. And here she looks cute, but from my viewpoint she loses a little bit of royalty in that particular look. Here she was trying to make her look a bit more sculpted and more feminine, with all curls and rounded features. And as a contrast, you can immediately see the angularity of the bone structure of the face. Even though we only look at the faces today, we don't look face plus body, but we can already see, because the facial bones already tell us about the way she's built. So we can see that softer hair color and that rounded everything, like soft everything. It's too rounded for her. On this picture is also better, I think, because the hair color is more uniform. I think it looks better on her. It gives more contrast with her light skin, with her light eyes. Again, kind of naturalish hair, but the fringe on the side has a little bit more statement. The look is more clean, and I love that eyeliner on her as well. Now let's look at her without any fringe. Look at that. Look at how great her face looks when it's clear, when she doesn't try to hide any of her jawline, any of her big forehead. How beautiful and powerful that looks, and how clean, and how much chic that adds to her, from my viewpoint. Looks like she doesn't have to do anything else. Some lashes, bright red lipstick, she's done. She doesn't have to pretend to be somebody else. Also, she looks gorgeous with smoky eyes, I think. Zoe Saldana. First, let's look at her without any bangs. Looks gorgeous, right? Again, very clean look. Beautiful, slightly angular face. Very sensual, very feminine. But when she's adding a little bit of that fringe, wispy fringe, she still looks beautiful, but she looks like anybody else, if I can say so. And here she is with very short bangs. It's a wig, I think. You can see, first of all, that if the hair color and the skin color is not contrasted enough, sometimes that washes them out a little bit, making them slightly more tired. We can't judge on that picture because that's a photo set. It has lighting, it has bright makeup, it has everything. We mostly talk about real life, and of course, ideally, if I had pictures from real life, that would make it all much easier for me and for you guys, but unfortunately it's very hard to find. But interesting how you can now see that part of her features, how strong she actually is. Look at that beautiful strong neck that she has, that bone that she has. Now soft classic. They can be smaller, they can have some flesh, some roundness, but they're still very balanced. So for soft classics, hair is best when it's controlled, smooth, soft, and blunt. They don't look as good with boyish and geometric cuts. So when we talk about bangs, I think they can look pretty nice with bangs, with softer bangs, with rounder bangs, with wispier styles, but I still think that when the look is clean, is the best thing for them because it doesn't distract from their clear facial features. So when we talk about Naomi Watts, she sometimes is experimenting with different types of bangs, most of her bangs are longer and slightly rounded. She never has that super heavy bangs. Sometimes her bangs are on a side, rounded, but I still think that her best looks are without bangs, with those nice, airy looking hair by her face. When the face is opened, Marion Cotillard, she was experimenting a lot, so I'm glad that we can see so many examples of soft classic with so many different hairstyles. That's her with short bangs, gamine-ish bangs. From my viewpoint, her roundness shows off more, and I think that's too boyish and too angular. I would add some softness to her. However, the cuteness of the facial features and of the bangs kind of match. So again, if we talk about my previous video about bangs, facial proportions can really pull off that short bangs. Nothing is kind of against it. But today we're more talking about the overall essence of the body type and image identity, which would be more right to say when we talk about Kibi. Same here, very girly, slightly wispy, slightly noisy, I would say. Same here. Here she has that short gamine-ish bangs. Very cute, actually, I think. Again, it fits the proportions of the face. Does it fit the overall look when she starts speaking and when she's moving? Here as well, I think slightly too angular and a bit heavy. Straight line, circles, roundness, transparency. Here she's trying that natural vibe on the hair. That softness fits her, but that tousleness gives some noise to her. Let's just look at some examples of her without that. Let's just look at her clear face in more clean looks without bangs. I think it looks gorgeous on her when she opens her face like that. Kirsten Dunst, same situation. When she has those wispy bangs or bangs a la natural, that looks nice and pretty soft, but it adds some of that noise and maybe some simplicity to her. But as soon as she has that very long side swept bangs, I think that makes her face just clear look and gives that more soft classic kind of a vibe. Jessica Chastain. Again, look at that. When she has that bangs, yeah, she looks beautiful. It covers half of her face. It is hanging above her eyes. Slightly heavy, from my opinion, and it gives that very simple look. Especially with those ornate earrings. I think that type of bangs, that girly bangs, it just doesn't fit. It just gives that not chic appearance. Not very sophisticated looking. But as soon as she has that clear look, clean face, open face, look at how sophisticated that looks. How calm, how sensual. And of course, you can see that her hair is also pretty well groomed here. They're not over-teased and back-combed, or they're not tousled. They're very beautifully sculpted. Dakota Johnson. And again, we can see this example. I think she thinks that her forehead is very big, so she's trying to hide it all the time with the bangs. In the majority of the pictures, she's with bangs. Sometimes those bangs are longer, sometimes shorter, sometimes they're like more wispy, like girly bangs, sometimes they are more rich and more angular looking, sometimes she has those curtain bangs. But again, I see what I see. I see as soon as she's not wearing any bangs, some sophistication is just coming back to her face. I don't know, something is happening with classics when they don't wear bangs. Some royalty is happening, I don't know, like some chic is coming back, you know? So for her, I also think that she looks best without bangs, with a very clear look. She was experimenting a lot with the hair color as well, when it was super yellowish light. She was experimenting with that straight hair, slightly rocky, punkish hair, with that wispy straight bangs. That's even further from soft classics. And I think she looks very nice with side swept bangs, when it's sculpted here, when it doesn't have all those wispiness.